What are the solutions to the current challenges facing the country? First and foremost is for all of us to understand that there is no magician that can set Nigeria on the right path without the collective participation of all Nigerians. Nigerians must understand that our current challenges are man-made. Our challenges are man-made. If our challenges are man-made, then they are challenges that can be resolved only by us. Almighty Allah has been fair to us. He has given us, among nations, the best of climatic conditions, the best of natural resources, the best of environment, the best of mineral resources, the best of the best. That is why in Nigeria, if we get it right, the first thing we must do is to try and ruminate over the causes. And they are before us. Corruption, number one. Number two, corruption. Number three, corruption. Some people say leadership, leadership, leadership. Yes, but the leadership of Muhammadu Buhari, who has been trying his best to recover the stolen money. Without all this recovery, several people will still say that nothing was stolen. Several people, especially those who say that stealing is not corruption. But alhamdulillah, for the recovery, and many people will say, where are the recovered loot? In the judicial process, you cannot take charge of the recovered loot now. They are still exhibits before the courts. So how do we recover them after the case? Talk to the lawyers who are defending corrupt people. Talk to the judges who are giving judgment in favor of corrupt people. Not all lawyers are corrupt. Not all judges are corrupt. Not all Nigerians are corrupt. But the few ones, they are derailing the system. And the wise, the average Nigerian who is a wise man, is now being misled because they make so much noise as if the problem solver is the problem creator. Buhari is not a magician. The money has been stolen. The foreign reserves have been stolen. The dollars have been stolen. Why do we have crisis with the dollars? There will be crisis with dollar. Dollar will continue to rise because we do not have competitive advantage any longer. Number one, our foreign reserve, the money we have, they shared it among themselves. When a whole central bank governor alerted us that $20 billion was missing, he said it. Go and watch the video, the documentary. I still have it. And watch what was said by Okonjo Iweala, the former minister. She said it. I can send it to you. She said it that our government refused to save. She indicted that government. That they refused to save, and that government, the past government, is the cause of the current problem. Their own minister said it. You want to know more than them? They stole the money, they shared the money. From one person's custody, they recovered $9.8 million cash. Some people say leadership, leadership, leadership. Yes, but the leadership of Muhammadu Buhari, who has been trying his best to recover the stolen money. Without all this recovery, several people will still say that nothing was stolen. Several people, especially those who said that stealing is not corruption. But alhamdulillah, for the recovery, and many people will say, where are the recovered loot? In the judicial process, you cannot take charge of of the recovered loot now, they are still exhibits before the courts. So how do we recover them after the case? Talk to the lawyers who are defending corrupt people. Talk to the judges who are giving judgment in favor of corrupt people. Not all lawyers are corrupt. Not all judges are corrupt. Not all Nigerians are corrupt. But the few ones, they are derailing the system. And the wise, the average Nigerian who is a wise man, is now being misled because they make so much noise as if the problem solver is the problem creator. Buhari is not a magician. The money has been stolen. The foreign reserves have been stolen. The dollars have been stolen. Why do we have crisis with the dollars? There will be crisis with dollar. Dollar will continue to rise because we do not have competitive advantage any longer. Number one, our foreign reserve, the money we have, they shared it among themselves. When a whole central bank governor alerted us that $20 billion was missing, he said it. Go and watch the video, the documentary. I still have it. And watch what was said by Okonjo-Iweala, the former minister. She said it. I can send it to you. She said it that our government refused to save. She indicted that government. That they refused to save, and that government, the past government, is the cause of the current problem. Their own minister said it. You want to know more than them? They stole the money, they shared the money from one person's in one person's custody. They recovered $9.8 million cash. Is something wrong with us? People are not demonstrating because of that. People are demonstrating because of an innocent leader who has decided not to compromise, who has beaten all of them to it. Now you will talk about the north. Is it time for us to be talking of north, south, west, and east? Is that our problem now, or corruption? Now we thank God that a northerner, Magu, was able to arrest a northerner, Andrew Yakubu, who stole the millions of dollars under the leadership of a northerner, President Buhari. Because instead of us to address matters, we'll be talking of ethnicity. They are diversionary tactics. It no longer works. He has shown the right body language for all Nigerians to know that our president is not a thief. None of you, no Nigerian has been able to say that he is a thief, that Buhari is a thief. You have not been able to say that. Look at him and Oshibajo. Is it about religion? They are doing their best. They are running the nation at the most challenging time when Nigerians are no longer ready to be patient. We need to be patient. We need to be patient. May we not witness war in this country. Because when you steal the nation's wealth, your plan is to destroy the nation at the expense of your own unborn children. Number two, why do we have crisis with the dollars? Are we producing anything? Is it what we produce that we eat? So when he said, don't bring rice in, people started blaming him. Why? Let them bring rice in. Rice is now 28,000. Yeah, it will be expensive because we no longer want to buy it. Let's look elsewhere. We will not die without rice. Let's go back to the farm. Let everybody be involved. The fertile ground, agricultural land, they are waiting for us, crying for cultivation. We are here expecting magic. Until we begin to eat only what we produce. It's a decision that must be taken by all. There is no magic. Now we sell crude oil. Some people, they have the audacity to tell you that we will blow the pipeline and nobody is protesting on the road. And they kept on blowing the pipeline. So the millions of barrels that we used to sell, we no longer have the capacity to sell the millions of barrels. So now, when you have weak naira, you complain. It's arithmetic now. What have we put in the market? Nigerians, we need patience. We need patience. We need perseverance. We need endurance. We need to buy in into the change mantra. I said it, it took Ghana. Ghana, very close to us, 26 years to pass through this phase. Look at the image of Ghana. America now gives Ghana free entry into their country, at least for the first few months. It's integrity. They worked for it. It took Singapore 30 years to get it right. It took Malaysia 22 years to get it right. It will take us time. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants the buy-in of everybody. Put religion aside. A thief is a thief. A criminal is a criminal. They stole millions of dollars. In China, it is death sentence. Try it in China. Stealing in China, corruption, is death. Because the money they have stolen, you are saying, why is Buhari not treating himself in Nigeria? With you demonstrating, saying the man should die. So he should come and treat himself in your own hospital. So you quickly give him injection to die. Who can be trusted in Nigeria? Look at reasonable people marching on the road, shouting Buhari must die. As if they are picking Ogogoro. Will you wish that your own father should die? What has he done? Because he took over the leadership and he's arresting corrupt people. And you were, he's not the judge, he's not the lawyer. He can only arrest and begin prosecution. Unless you, the judge, agrees that corruption must be fought and killed. Unless you, the lawyer, agrees that corruption must be fought and killed. Unless the policeman, the army, the custom officer, the immigration officer, the average Nigerian, the traditional ruler, everybody, until you agree, Nigeria will remain as it is. There is no magic anywhere. In the lala, you get Yiruma, become me hata, you get Yiruma, be amfusi. Allah says, I will not change anything that you are suffering from unless you change yourself. Some people, when you know the kidnapper in your environment, police will now put their own life at risk to arrest the kidnapper. The people in the environment, they will come together and kill the policeman for arresting somebody in their domain. So that shows that we have given approval to lawlessness. Even when they saw the photograph of Buhari and Tinubu and Baba Akande, they said, does this man have only one cloth? Why are you allowing yourself to be deceived? The man is on life support machine. This cannot be Buhari. Then the next minute, when Dogara and the Senate President, Saraki, and Lawan visited him, Nigeria started saying, look at Photoshop, Photoshop, Photoshopping, Photoshopping. This is not Buhari. Look at him. Let him speak to us. He's coming to speak to you. One thing I love most was his decision to obey his doctors. If he lies, let him be there 6 months. Is Nigeria not going on? Don't you have an acting president? Will the acting president have more power than he has now? Do you know the meaning of acting president? He could do anything. Is he not doing Federal Executive Council meeting? Nigeria is going on. Buhari is a symbol of integrity. is a symbol of honesty. It's a symbol of selflessness. And the leader that Nigeria needs now. If there's any Nigerian who has gone to Buhari to go and ask him to arrange something mischievous, come and tell us. You need this type of leader. You need to cooperate. Nigeria is extremely complex to govern. Nigerians must be prayerful and be patient to reap the fruits of our sacrifice. Ethiopia took them 12 years. Buhari, how many years? 4 years. He has only 4 years. So people are already saying he's going to contest again. Is that what we need now? Or for all of us to know that we ourselves must be ready to cooperate physically, materially, spiritually with whoever gets there. There is no one size fits all. There is no Nigerian who can fix Nigeria without the cooperation of all Nigerians. So if I arrest somebody and somebody discharge and acquits him, so have I done anything? Therefore, Nigerians, we need istighfar. We need to seek forgiveness, because forgiveness brings the grace and rahmah of Allah. Number two, we need patience. We need to be very patient. It is a trial from Allah, even though this trial is man-made. But for every trial, there is a solution. What has Allah said that has not manifested? If he says, I will test you, while I will not be ashamed in Allah, I test you with fear, are we not afraid? Do we know who has come here with bomb now? We don't know. While he jui hunger, are we not hungry? What has Allah said that has not manifested? Wanoksi min al-amwal, reduction in wealth. Are we not suffering from it? Wala anfus, and loss of lives. Have we not lost several lives to the Boko Haram menace? Wasamarat, nobody in the north dare go to their farm. Even around us here, see kidnappers around the creeks. What did Allah say that will make you succeed? Wabashiri sabirin. Allah says, give glad tidings to those who are patient. You need patience 3 times in your life. Asabru ala ta'a, to follow the law of Allah, you need to be patient. It's only when you are patient that you will not steal and you won't die. It's when you are patient, you will not commit fornication and adultery, and you won't die. When you are patient, you will not kill anybody so that you have money. Some people, they took only 40,000 naira was what they were able to get. Armed robbers, and they killed the man for having only 40,000. Asopra Anile Masia, you need patience to avoid mischief. So when anything is happening, you just say, what is it all about? What is all this about? It's just for some time. You see, we are hungry. Yes, we are hungry. Must we lose our senses because we are hungry? No! Because hunger is temporary. Even when you are well fed, it is temporary. You have been created to eat something, and something else has been created to eat you. So instead of you to thank Allah for what you have eaten in the past and prepare to be eaten in the grave, you are fighting because you have not eaten more. Forgetting the fact that we created the current problem ourselves out of greed. The next solution is love. Nigerians, we need to love ourselves regardless of your religion. Irrespective of your tribe, irrespective of your color, the Nigerian nation is created by God. and must be made to survive by Nigerians. So when people shout Biafra, we want to go away. Where are you going to? Are Igbo people that are extremely righteous, and the Yorubas are corrupt and Hausas are corrupt? Is that what you are trying to say? No. Righteousness is not about the color. It's not about the language. Let's come together. Nigeria must survive. An Igbo man is a good person. A Yoruba man is a good person. A Hausa man is a good person. This is how we must reason. So when we see someone who is a criminal, we say, you are not a true Hausa man. You are not a true Yoruba man. You are not a true Igbo man. Because we are all the children of Adam. So don't be too arrogant about Biafra. Silently, if there's any state that wish to be alone, is it not Lagos State? Should we send all the Igbo people away from Lagos? You know, you don't think deeply about what you say. Should Lagosians decide that we want to take over our thing, will you have peace here? Don't say that. There are so many Yorubas in Kano. We are meant to live together. Stop talking about ethnicity and tribalism. Among those who destroy this country, there are Yoruba people. Among those who destroy Nigeria, there are Hausa. Among those who destroy Nigeria, there are Igbos and people from the South. Which does not mean that there are no righteous people from these nations. Professor Salam says, whoever thinks of ethnicity, tribalism, they don't belong to me, Muhammad. Another way out of our current challenges is for us to demonstrate contentment. Contentment is for you to know that my Lord is wise. I may be interested in a particular thing, but if I think deeply, he has given me the best, more than what I can ever aspire to be. Look at what Allah has given you. It's greater than material things. What he has given you, you know, I just gave you an example. I said, if I live here, I have a lecture at Kirikiri Maximum Prison. They are looking forward to that lecture. You are free. You can go out of this mosque now. Attend any lecture. NASFAT, Kori, TMC, MSS, Companion. You can, anywhere you can. But they cannot leave the spot where they are. So the freedom to move at all is a great wealth Allah has granted you. There are so many people in the hospitals. They are not imprisoned, but they cannot move. They must not step out of the hospital. Here you are, so wealthy, so healthy. Look at yourself and say, Alhamdulillah. Nigerians, we need to be informed of the numerous blessings of Almighty Allah, the immeasurable favors of Allah, so that we ask ourselves, must I go to the road and protest over what? Over what is reasonably predictable? Nothing is erratic about Nigeria. It is reasonably predictable that when you steal, you lack. When you steal your own resources, you lose competitive advantage. When you steal your own dollars, you have no dollars to import. Therefore, your naira continues to weaken. When you don't produce anything, your naira is forever very weak. But when you produce what others will buy, they need to seek your naira because they want your products. There is no magician that can fix Nigeria without the active cooperation of all Nigerians. How about your kids, your children? What do you say to them? What training do you give to them? Speak to them. Speak with them. You speak to them when you are giving instruction. You speak with them when you are listening to their challenges and tell them to praise Allah. There's a difference between what you need and what you want. Nigerians must learn contentment. I just said it when I was delivering the Yoruba lecture that in UK today and all the countries in winter, if they dare take the light now, they die. Protest over those ones so that others will stop. Not for us to be frustrating the efforts of people who were elected, who are trying their best to arrest the thieves and say they should be prosecuted. You did not vote for any lawyer. But that lawyer who is defending the corrupt man needs to know that he is destroying us by half. That judge who is silently negotiating for his own part of the money is destroying us by half. And the effort of this man will not materialize until you and I key into it. So we need participation, we need contentment, we need to be prayerful, be supportive of the government. This is not a campaign. This is an attempt to look for solution as Allah has enshrined in the Quran and as the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam has taught us, there is no problem without solution. But the symptoms, we only complain of the symptoms. The prices are skyrocketing. We fail to look at the causes. For every symptom, there is a cause. Now, what is the cause? The people you are causing today or abusing did not take part in bringing it about. They are part of the rescue mission. But the mistake we made is thinking that they have a magic to perform when the house is nearly completely destroyed. You and I must key in. We have the high population to send away criminals from this country. But if the population is having a lackadaisical attitude and say they are the ones to do it, never. Let me conclude with the story I told you here. And that story is about the pilot and our journey from here to Port Harcourt. From here to Port Harcourt shouldn't take more than 1 hour at most. But in 2 hours, the plane was yet to land. The pilot was having challenges. Then he spoke. And you know, pilot, they won't speak out very well. But the only thing that was clear was when he said, ladies and gentlemen, we are having challenges and that. So challenges is the only thing that people underline. To land the plane, he was having challenges. So when he said it, one man stood up. He brought out his ID card and gave it to one of the crew members. The man happened to be a pilot himself. He was taking his own father to one hospital in Port Harcourt. So he said they should take that ID card to the cockpit to show the pilot. So when the pilot saw it, he said they should bring him in. It was that man that Allah used to land the plane. Never see yourself as a passenger when it is time for you to act. The rescue mission is a holistic project. No one should be underrated. There is no one. Because if you continue to fill the gallon, but it's leaking somewhere, it will never be filled up. Check if you are the leakage. Check if Nigeria is getting troubled through your agency. Check. And that is the whole idea of change begins with me. It's not a political campaign. It's the most reasonable thing. When I was in Canada, I saw what it means to believe that change begins with me. I was used to it. I was used to one thing. If I buy anything from anybody and the change remains something that I can afford, I leave it. And many of you do the same. You just leave it because it's something you can afford. In Canada, after the Jumat service, we were coming and we got to a supermarket. We bought things. I think it remains like $50 or whatever. I asked the lady to take it. Say, why? Please don't embarrass me. Look, three questions in one. Why? Please don't embarrass. I quickly collected my money. We will get to that stage, inshallah. And come to think of it, their children go to school without stress. They go to hospitals without stress. But you know what? They pay for everything. Go and check. Whether in America, whether in London, everywhere, nothing is free. They collect it from your money in a manner that is convenient. And they explain to you, this is what we use your money for. So until we cultivate the habit that things cannot be free now, we will still get to a stage when things will be like free, but never free. When our children will now go to school and nobody will ask them of their school fees. Because from the taxpayers' money, there is enough money to pay the salaries of lecturers and then put facilities in the school. We will get there. You and I should not think of ourselves. We should think of generations unborn. If the effect of the struggle now will eventually lead to a successful life for our unborn generation, so be it. If I will be consumed by the sacrifice at this time and die without witnessing it, so be it. Let our children and our great-grandchildren not meet this. May Allah purify our souls. May Allah forgive us our sins. May Allah strengthen all of us. May Allah strengthen our resolve in this country. May Allah assist our leaders. May Allah assist the followers. Rabbana taqabbal minna innaka antas samiul alim. Wa tub alayna ya maulana innaka antat tawwabur rahim. Rabbana atina fid dunya hasanatan wa fil akhirati hasanatan wa qina azaban nar. Wa adkhilna lil jannati ma'al abrar. Ya aziz ya ghafar. Ya Allah ya rabbal alamin. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad kama sallaita ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim wa barik ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad kama barakta ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim innaka Hamidum Majid subhanaka allahumma bihamdika wa nashhadu an la ilaha illa anta wa nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk subhana rabbika rabbil izzati amma yasifun. Assalamu ala al-mursaleen, walhamdulillah.